We're on Capitol Hill today in front of the White Community Memorial Chapel, which sits just behind me. This is a unique building in Salt Lake City because it's a replica of a 19th century LDS meeting house that used to sit just off the hill here. On February 14, 1849, just 2 years after the pioneers entered the Salt Lake Valley, Brigham Young organized all the Latter-day Saints into 19 wards, and this was the meeting house for the 18th ward. The original building was the first in the Salt Lake Valley to have a steeple on it. The steeple you see here on this building is the original steeple from that building, which was moved here when this building was reconstructed in 1975. Wilford Woodruff was president of the church in 1892, the year prior to when the Salt Lake Temple was dedicated. It had taken the saints 39 years to raise the granite walls. During this time, there was some feeling among the workers that the Salt Lake Temple could never be completed in time for the proposed dedication date in April 1893. There was some discussion about finishing the spires in pine, stained to look like granite, rather than of granite itself. President Woodruff called a meeting in the 18th Ward building and shared with church leaders his feelings on the matter. He related that on the evening of the 6th of July, 1841, 6 years before the Saints came west, he was in the Lafayette Hotel in Boston, Massachusetts, serving a mission. That evening, he had a dream in which he was shown the future. He saw the Saints migrate to the Rocky Mountains, build a temple, and dedicate it, and that, quote, at the dedicatory services, elders were set apart to go among the Gentile nations to bind the law and seal the testimony, unquote. Now, some 50 years later, on the 7th of October, 1891, in this meeting with the presidents of stakes and bishops in the 18th Ward Schoolhouse, the 18th Ward Chapel, President Woodruff shared what he had seen regarding the construction of the Salt Lake Temple in his vision. The First Presidency, Council of the Twelve, and Presiding Bishopric were also in attendance. President Woodruff related the dream he had 50 years earlier and that he knew the granite temple would be finished in time for the dedication. It was his talk that night in the 18th Ward Chapel that motivated the saints to go forward with their might and complete the temple of granite as had been originally planned. One of the construction miracles of the Salt Lake Temple is that the roof, the floors, and all the interior work was finished in 1 year, and the temple was dedicated on the 6th of April, 1893, precisely as Wilford Woodruff had been shown in vision, and the steeples were made of granite, just as he'd seen. Today, this building is used for civic and religious purposes, but originally, it was the building in which the first LDS Junior Sunday School program was launched, and it was also the building where the first Boy Scout troop was organized in the state of Utah. In 1975, the old LDS 18th Ward was taken apart and dismantled because larger room was needed, larger space, and it was reconstructed on this site, land donated by the Utah State Legislature, with the agreement that it would become a civic and social center for the state of Utah.
For more information on Hallowed Ground Sacred Journeys, please visit virtualtours.byu.edu.